69. Seventy.
Present, sir.
71.
Present, sir.
72.
Present, sir.
73.
Present, sir.
74.
Present, sir.
75.
Present, sir.
76.
Present, sir.
77.
Present, sir.
78.
Yes, sir.
79.
Present, sir.
80.
Present, sir.
81.
Present, sir.
82.
Yes, sir.
83.
Yes, sir.
84.
Present, sir.
85.
Present, sir.
86.
Present, sir.
87. 87 is not here. 88.
Present, sir.
89.
Present, sir.
90.
Present, sir.
91.
Present, sir.
92. Is not here. 93. 94.
Present, sir.
95.
Present, sir.
96.
Present, sir.
97.
Present, sir.
98. 99. 800.
Present, sir.
801. 2.
Present, sir.
3.
Yes, sir.
4.
Present, sir.
5.
Present, sir.
6.
Present, sir.
7.
Present, sir.
8.
Present, sir.
9. 9. Not here. 10.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19. Is not here. 20. Not here. 21. 21. Samudra Neel Sen Gupta. Not here. 22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24. 24. 25. 26.
Present, sir.
27.
Present, sir.
28.
Present, sir.
29.
Present, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32. 33. 33. 34.
Present, sir.
35. 36.
Present, sir.
37. Not here. 38.
Present, sir.
39.
Present, sir.
40.
Present, sir.
41.
Present, sir.
42.
Present, sir.
43.
Present, sir.
44. 44. 45.
Present, sir.
46.
Present, sir.
47.
Present, sir.
48.
Present, sir.
49.
Present, sir.
50.
Present, sir.
I'll just call the absentees in case if you are here, let me know. 69. 69.
Yes, sir.
On the chat box. Sir,
69 is
present. Then.
Hello.
Yes, 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 I can hear you. 87.
Yes, sir, present, sir.
Then 92, 93, 98.
Present, sir.
98 is present. 99, 801, 809, 819, 820. 821. These are permanent absentees. Then we have 824, 825, 835, 833, 837, 841. 844. Yeah, so these are the absentees for today. So last class mein hum cell padh rahe the, and I have already shared you about this PPT also. So next we have to start cell division process, but before understanding the cell division process, you have to understand what is the DNA, what is the RNA, the chromosome kya hota hai, and what are the different types of chromosomes and all. Okay, so let's begin with the so-called formation of the nucleic acids. But before that, let's just interact regarding the recent classes. Last class mein hum kuch padhe the, we studied something about cells and all. So let's have some interaction regarding the same. Okay, Anushka Jena, roll number 774.
Yes, sir.
Anushka Jena, can you please tell me what is the functioning of a mitochondria? Mitochondria ka function kya hai? We have
powerhouse
of the cell.
It's the powerhouse of the cell. Okay. You all can give random answers. Fine then. What is the function of reticulum? Endoplasmic reticulum.
It helps to move substances within the cell.
Yeah, transportation is the common function. Where are lipids produced? In which endoplasmic reticulums are the lipids produced?
Rough endoplasmic reticulum.
No. That's smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Where do we see detoxification process? Detoxification. Again, it's smooth endoplasmic reticulum.
Endoplasmic reticulum.
Yeah, that's smooth endoplasmic reticulum. We have two endoplasmic reticulums. One is rough and one is smooth. Okay. In a nucleus, we have a darker region. So, what do we have in the darker region? The darker region is called as nucleolus. What do we have in darker region?
Chromosomes.
No, chromosomes are not on the darker region. So they are on the
light region. Genetic material.
No, not the genetic material.
Ribosomes?
RNA, yeah. RNA and ribosomal compartments are available in the darker region. In the nucleolus, we have RNA and ribosomes. Remember this. Then what about Golgi apparatus? What does it do?
Storage and modification.
Food storage.
Of metals.
Synthesis no. Of plant cell wall.
Yeah, in plants, yeah, it synthesizes the cell wall. Good, very good. And not just that, see, it's not storage. I told you.
It's packaging of proteins.
Packing
into membranes bound.
Yes, it's a packing and sorting facility of the cell. Okay, so how does it pack? It uses the membrane, and then the same is going as a vesicle. And this vesicle can stay as a storage vesicle, or it can go as a transportation vesicle. Okay. What about so-called cytoplasm? Cytoplasm ka role kya hai cell mein? Cytoplasm is the liquid component of the cell. What does it do?
So responsible for holding the cell and protect them from damage.
Responsible for
holding the components of the cell
holding and the organelles. Okay, holding the organelles, provides all the media. Fine. Yes, and also it takes parts in transportation, it takes parts in metabolism.
It is responsible for shape of cell.
Not exactly, it is responsible for the shape of the cell, but
cell expansion.
The storage substances.
It is also acting as storing of certain substances. It also acts as a region for storing of certain substances, right? Shape of the cell is actually coming out because of cytoskeleton, not cytoplasm. Okay, cyto ka matlab kya hota hai? Cyto matlab cell. Okay, so both of them are different. Cytoskeleton is different and cytoplasm is different. Plant or animal, dono ke beech mein teen differences bata dijiye. Plant or animal ke beech mein, plant cell, animal cell.
Sir, plant cell wall,
animal don't have cell wall, plant have cell wall. One, okay.
Animal cells have centrosomes, plants don't have centrosomes.
Right. Animal cells
are plant, cell have a chloroplast, but animal cell do not have chloroplast.
Right. Plant cells has chloroplast, animal cells don't have. Plant cell has vacuole, animal cells don't have. Animal cells has lysosomes.
Have a small vacuole.
Yeah.
Animal cell has lysosome, plant cells don't have it. Okay, these are some of the differences. Good. Abhi prokaryote and eukaryote ke beech mein antar bata dijiye. तीन अंतर बता दीजिए. थ्री differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Pro and you.
Sir, nucleus cell membrane से bounded नहीं रहता.
No, availability of nucleus. It's basically availability of nucleus. So we don't have a well bounded structure called as nucleus in prokaryote, and in eukaryote we have it. And based on that only we are calling them as pro or you. Okay, that's one difference. More.
Nucleus matlab have a membrane bounded nucleus in eukaryotic cell, and prokaryotic cell do not have.
Yeah, that's the primary difference. Ye wo ho gaya hai, uske alawa aur differences bata dijiye.
Prokaryotic is unicellular.
The organelles are not bounded by membranes.
Yeah. There are no organelles in prokaryotic structure, whereas in eukaryotic cell
DNA structures are also.
We have very many range of organelles which are bound with membranes. Fine. Number three.
DNA structure.
DNA structure, nahin, DNA formation, like chromosome formation. It's
yes, sir.
The DNA gets compacted and form a single circular chromosome. Whereas in eukaryotes, availability of chromosomes can vary and they are multiple in number. It's not single. Okay. Fine, very good. And number four, you can include ribosomes. Ribosomes are of 70 sedimentation type, S type, Swedberg unit type. And in eukaryotes, ribosomes are of 80 S types. Okay, so ribosomes are smaller in prokaryotes and they are a bit bigger in eukaryotes. So these are some of the functions. So cytoplasm here is performing the entire activities. Okay, so there is no division of labor, whereas in eukaryotes there is a division of labor. So all of these can be included. Fine, we will go ahead with the next class. So let's understand the concept of so-called gene and all. Let me share my screen. Yeah. So now we were talking about DNA and all. So we have been taught from many days that DNA is actually carrying out genetic material. Okay, whatever our genetic content is there, that's carried by DNA. So how does this DNA carry it? Okay, so our DNA is basically made up of three structural entities or three chemical compounds. One is a compound called as nitrogen base, and the other compound is sugar, and the other compound is a phosphate. Okay, all of them together we can call them as nucleic acid. Okay, so we have different types of nucleic acids available in nature, and two are usually used for hereditary purpose. One is RNA and the other one is DNA. RNA, you see most of the viruses, they do use RNA. Like now we have coronavirus genetic content is on RNA. Okay, whereas DNA, or rest of the creatures, like from microorganisms till human beings, we all have DNA as a hereditary content. Okay, so now when you are talking about hereditary material, what is this hereditary material and what does it have? So it has this entire body has a lot of genetic content, and this genetic content has multiple number of genes. We have genes for eyes, we have genes for eyebrows, we have genes for our hair, hair color, कितना hair होना चाहिए, शायद वो आदमी bald हो सकता है, or it can be like he can have curly hair or it can have straight hair. All these characters basically are depicted by the genes in your body. Okay, so there are multiple varieties of genes like that. We have like some millions and millions of genes located on our entire DNA. So now this gene, whatever the gene is there, this gene shows diversity with one another. Matlab, I may a human ho, you're all like approximately 75 humans in the class. So when we are comparing with respect to a specific trait, let's say nose. Okay, so nose formation mein agar hum compare karenge ek dusre se, you will not find an exact match. Okay, we have a bit of difference with each other with respect to the structure, with respect to the color, with respect to the surface and all. Okay, so we have some sort of a variation being observed. This is basically happening at a genetic level. Okay, so hamara genes mein thoda bahut antar hai. So what are these genes made up of? They are made up of codes. It's called as genetic code. Okay, just like the way we are running computer with this binary code. Okay, so the life performance is depicted by or dictated by something called as a genetic code. So this genetic code is a combination of some of your bases. We call it as nucleotides. Okay, so this way the lower hierarchy keeps happening. Okay, so now today we are going to see how actually these things are formed. See, as I was mentioning here, first of all, I have to ask you, is my slide visible to you all?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, visible to all. Okay, so you can see here, this is our nucleus, this is our hereditary content. So this is our hereditary content. If you are prolonging it, it's nothing but it's a long chain of DNA. On the long chain of DNA, you can find multiple genes, and each and every gene, this is made up of these bases. And these bases together will be forming certain thing, components, short components called as genetic codes. Okay, and these genetic codes can vary, and this is where we are getting variations in our nature. Okay, so let's study about these structures that we have talking about. Okay, so let's go with the so-called formation of DNA and RNA. Now you all must be thinking ki jab ye viral particles mein RNA hai, okay, when these viral particles are RNA and when it is acting as this genetic content, why isn't the nature made that way? Okay, why we have DNA separately? And if you're going to look at DNA and RNA, you see RNA is stable as a single chain form, whereas DNA is stable as a double chain form. Okay, so there are like multiple questions to it. There are multiple questions, there are multiple explanations. I'll just tell you why we are choosing DNA over RNA. Okay, so you will be understanding it in the due course of time, probably in this class only. Okay, so we have two different kinds of nucleic acids. One is deoxyribonucleic acid. This is your deoxyribonucleic acid. And the other one is ribonucleic acid. This is your RNA. Okay, so what are these made up of? They are made up of three structural components. Number one is a nitrogen base. Okay, and number two is a sugar, which is 5-sugar, pentose sugar. And number three is a phosphate, PO4. So PO4 is very important for the living performances. Okay, our jitna bhi activity hai in the course of evolution of the earth, when oxygen came onto the earth, this oxygen was able to form certain high energy molecules like carbonyls, like phosphates. So all of these high energy molecules are very much important for the living processes. Okay, because the kind of the energy they bear, when you are breaking it down, it is going to it is going to release the energy in such a way that through this energy, some reactions can happen at a go. Okay, it's not just one reaction, many reactions can happen at a go. Okay, that is the kind of the energy that these particular molecules bear. Okay, so while the Earth evolved and while the living creatures started to appear, okay, phosphate is one of the crucial molecule which took part in so-called assembly and rest of the stuff. Okay, and the availability of the molecule has played a prominent role till date. Okay, even today, if you're going to look at the phosphate molecule, you see we have an energy molecule produced by mitochondria. We are calling it as ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Okay, so we have the availability of phosphate as an energy molecule still today. आज तक भी हम फॉस्फेट को यूज करते हैं एनर्जी मॉलिक्यूल की तरह. ओके, सो आवर डीएनए एंड आवर आरएनए बेसिकली हैव दिस थ्री डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स. नंबर वन इज अ नाइट्रोजन बेस एंड नंबर टू इज अ शुगर एंड नंबर थ्री इज अ फॉस्फेट. सो लेट्स सी द फॉर्मेशंस. नाइट्रोजन बेस, व्हाट इज दिस नाइट्रोजन बेस? दिस इज नथिंग बट दिस इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ योर साइक्लिक कंपाउंड्स. We begin with the benzene. Let's say we have a benzene. I think all of you know the structure of benzene, right? We have six carbons in it with alternating double bonds, okay, between the carbons. So in this benzene structure, let's replace the first and third carbon with nitrogen. We are substituting the first carbon and the third carbon with a nitrogen. Okay. हमें बेंजीन स्ट्रक्चर में पहले कार्बन और तीसरे कार्बन को हटा के हम नाइट्रोजन को ऐड कर दिया. दिस बेस, सिंपल बेस ऑफ बेंजीन व्हिच इज सब्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय टू नाइट्रोजन्स इज कॉल्ड एज पिरिमिडिन बेस. ओके, सो पिरिमिडिन क्या होता है? इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ एन एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड ओनली. इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ सिंपल एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड कॉल्ड बेंजीन व्हिच इज बीइंग सब्स्टिट्यूटेड विद टू नाइट्रोजन्स एट फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड पोजीशन. दैट्स कॉल्ड एज पिरिमिडिन. सो onto the pyrimidine. Now, depending upon the additional groups that we are adding, we have three different types of pyrimidines formed in nature. Number one is deoxypyrimidine. You see, we have oxygen availability at second and sixth carbons. So that's deoxypyrimidine. Okay. So deoxypyrimidine is called as uracil. And uracil, you see the first letter, it's abbreviated as capital U. Okay. Same way, we have dioxymethyl pyrimidine. Okay, or you can say methyl uracil. So methyl uracil is also called as thymine. Okay, same way we have deoxy group, but additionally we have a methyl group at fifth carbon. So this structure is called as thymine, abbreviated as capital T. Okay, and then we have third structure called as cytosine. So this is oxy amino. So we have oxy group and an amino group. So this oxy amino pyrimidine is called as cytosine. Okay, so we have three structures in pyrimidines. One is uracil, which is deoxy structure. Then we have oxy amino structure called as cytosine. Then we have a deoxy methyl structure called as thymine. So the arrangement varies from DNA to RNA. We'll be talking about it soon. Then we have a bit larger version of the nitrogen base called as purine. So what do we have in purine? We have the same structure of pyrimidine, and to this additional structure of pyrimidine, we are adding three more carbons. 1, 2, 3. Again, replace two more carbons with nitrogen. So we have total replacements of 1, 2, 3, 4. So this kind of a dual cyclic structure where you tend to see replacement of four carbons with nitrogen is called as purine. Okay, we are calling this structure as purine. Now on this purine, we have again two molecules that are being formed. Number one is adenine, which is addition of a simple amino group. Ek amino group ko humne add kar diya hai sixth carbon pe, and so we call this as adenine. Six amino purine is adenine. Then we have 2-amino-6-oxy purine. It's called as guanine, or you can simply call it as oxy amino purine. It's called as guanine. So we have an oxy amino formation in both the cases. Yahan pe oxy amino formation hai, and you are calling it as गोनेन यहाँ पे एक ऑक्सीअमिनो फॉर्मेशन है एंड वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज साइटोजेन. सो ऑक्सीअमिनो पिरिमिडिन इट्स साइटोजेन, ऑक्सीअमिनो प्यूरिन इट्स गोनेन. रिमेम्बर दैट. ओके यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेम्बर द स्ट्रक्चर. ओके आपको समझ में आने के लिए टू जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड फॉर अ बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई एम जस्ट टीचिंग यू द स्ट्रक्चर्स. ओके बिकॉज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ डीएनए इज वेरी मच क्रूशियल. ओके सो ये structures form ho gaya hai. So what are the bases that we have? We have purines, in purines we have adenine and guanine, in pyrimidines we have thymine, cytosine, uracil. Now distribution dekh lijiye, 1 2 3 4, the first four, first two purines and first two pyrimidines you tend to see in DNA. Okay, first two purines, adenine and guanine you see in DNA, thymine, cytosine you see in DNA. Okay, now going to RNA, same way you see adenine and guanine, these are common for both DNA and RNA, cytosine and uracil. So here it's, in case of RNA it's first two and last two pyrimidines. So cytosine and uracil. So what are common bases that you find between DNA and RNA? We find adenine, we find guanine, we find cytosine. These three are common in both DNA and RNA, but fourth base is different. What is different? We find only deoxypyrimidine in RNA, and in DNA we find methylated deoxypyrimidine. So thymine goes to DNA and uracil goes to RNA. So this is one difference of nitrogen base that we see in DNA and RNA. Okay, kya difference hai? Pehla difference ye hai, nitrogen base ka ek pyrimidine base mein antar hai. डीएनए में थायमिन होगा, टी होगा, और आरएनए में यू होगा, टी के प्लेस में यू होगा. ओके सो दिस इज वन डिफरेंस. नाउ कमिंग टू द शुगर, सेकंड कंपोनेंट कॉल्ड शुगर. सो वी आर यूजिंग, या समबडी हैज सम क्वेरी.
सॉरी सर, बाय मिस्टेक
गलती से लग गया है, कोई बात नहीं. कमिंग टू द second component, the second component is ribose. So if you're going to look at the sugar, this is a pentose sugar called as ribose, pentose. Okay, pentose, hexose, the kind of the sugar that usually gives us energy is hexose. It's called glucose or fructose or galactose. All of these are hexoses. In case of plants, to make this glucose you require a pentose sugar, 5 sugar compound. Okay, so ribose is one of the 5 sugar compounds. So carbohydrates, as you all know, you can see each and every carbon has an OH group, and one of the carbon will be either having a keto group or aldehyde group. Okay, so such kind of chains of carbons are called as carbohydrates. Jisme ek carbon mein aapko ya to aldehyde hoga ya to ketone hoga, baaki sab carbons mein you have a OH group attached to it. So you can see here, this carbon has OH, this carbon has OH, this carbon has OH, this carbon also has OH, but this O is now here forming something called as a cyclic structure. Okay, and this also, the last one also has OH. Okay, so this way the sugar basically has what do you say, 5 carbons. This usually will be forming a ketone, the fourth one usually will be forming a ketone, but this is now we are taking a cyclic format. So this oxygen is now shared by 2 carbons. Okay, and this way we have 1, 2, 3, and 5th carbon is at the end. It's independent, it's not in the cycle. Okay, so this structure is called as furanose structure. So we have ribose and deoxyribose in this manner. Now looking at these two sugars, we find a small difference. Okay, ribo, deoxyribo, we are seeing it as deoxy, which means at some position the availability of oxygen is not same. What is the position? You see the second carbon. The second carbon here has OH. This is a common formation. Now we have a modification happening at this sugar. See, the second carbon, instead of OH, it has only H. Okay? Yahan pe sirf H hai, yahan pe OH hai. So this kind of a sugar is called as a sugar without oxygen. So we call it as deoxy ribose, and this is the ribose sugar. on the ribose sugar, we are deoxygenating it, and hence we are calling it as deoxyribose. So, if this sugar is building up with your nitrogen bases, अगर ये sugar आपके nitrogen bases से attach हो रहा है, तब हम वो molecule को क्या कहते हैं? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay? And if this sugar is attaching to your nitrogen base, then we call it as ribonucleic acid or simply RNA. So this is how we give the terms. So how, what is the deciding factor? DNA and RNA mein deciding factor kya hai? Sugar deciding factor hai. So if deoxyribose sugar is going, we see it as DNA. If ribose sugar is going, we see it as RNA. And now, as a sugar, out of this table, can somebody mention? Simply look at the groups that are been added. We have a C and a H, we have a C and OH. Which one is easy to break?
2-dioxyribose.
No, that is not dioxy. See, dioxy matlab wahan pe do oxygen hona chahiye. It's deoxy. Confused mat hoiye. Okay, don't get confused. Dioxy matlab you should have two oxygens. Deoxy matlab it is basically devoid of oxygen. Oxygen hai hi nahi wahan pe. Okay. Now dhyan se dekhiye. You see a CH interaction and you see a COH interaction. Which one is more stable? Is it CH and COH?
So CH.
Yes, CH is more stable. COH is less stable. The reason behind COH being less stable is availability of oxygen makes the compound to undergo easy oxidation process. Okay, so that's number one. And number two, what do you say? This OH group can actually take part in several other processes as well, and you have a chances of losing this structure. Okay, so the RNA, the so-called pentose sugar, can get disturbed here. Whereas here, comparatively to this sugar, this can stay for a long time because of this solo bond, CH. Okay, and hence deoxyribose tend to stay a bit longer than RNA. Okay, than your ribose. And not just that, we have this formation of DNA and RNA. We have these formations. We are getting the stability. Okay, when you are actually looking at the stability, you see we have a RNA existing as a single strand and DNA existing as double strand. Okay, so you don't have any extra bonding here. Whereas here you have some bonding happening between the two chains. Okay, so you have more number of bonds available here, and on top of that, your sugar is carrying a H, and this makes the molecule much stabler compared to this. So this in nature, if you want to see which is denaturing or degrading faster, it's your RNA that degrades faster than the DNA. Okay, but however, if you're going to look at the shelf life of these DNA and RNA, you still find the DNA available in matter coming up from like some thousands and thousands of years. Okay. Like let's take mummies and all. Okay, let's take fossils. Fossils are something that were hidden in earth or in glaciers for a long, long period of time. So from the fossil also you can actually extract the DNA and you can still study it. Okay, so you can't get the RNA. Okay, you can't get the RNA, but you can get the DNA. So this sort of a thing makes the DNA more stable, and that's the reason why most of the higher creatures like us have chosen DNA or RNA to store our genetic content. Okay, we have evolved in such a way. हम लोग का evolution ऐसे हुआ है कि we the molecules are that is better to have our genetic content on the DNA molecule but not on the RNA molecule. Okay, so this makes the DNA more stable, and this makes the RNA less stable. Okay, number two is sugar. Now, number three is phosphate, PO4, high energy transfer molecule. So let's look at the binding. So when you have a sugar, when you have a nitrogen base, the sugar and the nitrogen base links with a glycosidic bond. This is again a covalent interaction. And the bond is called as a glycosidic bond. Okay, basically the sugar based bonds usually are called as glycosidic bonds and they are covalent in nature. Okay, so you have your first carbon interacting with your first N. So that's your nitrogen base. Okay, so this is one interaction. The second interaction can come from your free carbon, which is the fifth carbon. The fifth carbon will be now taking part in binding to your phosphate. So how does the phosphate bind? Through a ester linkage. This linkage that you are seeing here, it's called as ester linkage. Okay, so phosphoester linkage ho gaya. So we have phosphoester linkage being happening with a carbon. Again, this is a kind of a covalent linkage. So we have one covalent linkage here, and you have another covalent linkage here. This is glycosidic linkage. This is phosphoester linkage. Okay, so this way we have formation of a nucleoside monophosphate. So now I told you some term, nucleotide, nucleoside. Okay, nucleoside kya hota hai? If you have only a nitrogen base, you see it as nitrogen base. If you have a nitrogen base with a sugar, then you call it as nucleoside. The same thing is being depicted here. Okay, nucleoside kya hota hai? If you have a base and a sugar, then we call it as nucleoside. Okay, for example, adenine, it's simple, nitrogen base. Adenosine is adenine plus ribose sugar, so that we call it as adenosine, or adenine plus deoxyribose sugar, we can also call it as adenosine. Okay, so adenosine is a nucleoside. Then followed by, if you have a single phosphate added, or a diphosphate added, phosphate addition makes it nucleotide. Okay, nucleoside ko agar hum phosphates add kar rahe, then we can call it as nucleotide. So side aur tide ke beech mein antar kya hai? Side mein sirf sugar hai, tide mein sugar ke sath phosphate bhi juda hua hai. Okay, so this is the structural formation of any kind of a nucleotide, nucleic acid. Okay, so we have base followed by nucleoside followed by nucleotide. Okay, and look at these high energy molecules. The high energy molecule can form a monostructure, a distructure, and a tristructure. Beyond tristructure, it is not stable. Okay, you take any high energy molecules, they cannot form long chains because of their internal energy that they bear. Okay, so they go as short chain forms and they stop. Okay, and this manner phosphates are able to form till 3 phosphates. Third phosphate tak pura molecule stable hai. Okay, and fourth phosphate onwards it is unstable, and hence you don't see the formation of a tetraphosphate or a hexaphosphate or a pentaphosphate and so on. Okay, you see only availability of phosphates as tri. Okay, and this way we have our energy molecules existing either in the form of a monophosphate or a diphosphate or a triphosphate. Usually triphosphate mein sabse jyada energy hai because we have 3 phosphates, and hence we are going ahead with this molecule. Okay, that is the reason why we have adenosine triphosphate acting as our energy molecule, ATP. Okay, so we have ATP acting as the energy molecule. And now a question to you all. We have this structure site, we have this adenine, then guanine, we have thymine, cytosine, uracil. These are we to have body mein. We have all of these structures in the body. So why adenine only is contributing as energy factor? Why not guanine has taken the chance? Why not thymine has taken the chance? These are we to have. They all also can form triphosphates, but they are not acting as energy molecules. Why? Can there be a reason? Can there be a reason?
So other than adenine, all are carbonyl compounds, right?
Yeah, other than adenine, rest of the compounds that you are seeing are carbonyl compounds. Okay, and second thing, you just look at the structure of the adenine. The formation of adenine in the nature took earlier. There is no oxygen in this. Okay, there is no oxygen. So availability of adenine on the earth came earlier, much earlier compared to these organs, compared to these compounds. Okay, so while the phosphates were already being formed, So adenine started to work with the phosphate earlier, much earlier than these. Okay? It doesn't mean that these molecules along with phosphate cannot bear energy or cannot function as energy molecules. They also can function as energy molecule, and it's some metabolic processes where adenine content is lacked. In that cases, guanine can take over and it can provide energy basis. Okay? Guanine, like GTP, GDP also can contribute to energy conversions in the cell. Okay? Pyrimidines, on the other hand, with the phosphates, compared to the purines, they participate lesser. The reason behind this is still yet unknown. We don't know why it is not happening, why our cell is not choosing them. Okay? But purines, yeah, both of the purines do contribute to energy processes. Adenine, as it is evolved much, much earlier, probably in the course of evolution, it has taken a major role in building up other cells and building up the cellular process. And probably that's the reason why we see most of the cells are using adenine, majorly, okay, and not the guanine. But however, at some points where adenine deficiency is seen, guanine can take over. Okay, it also can act as an energy molecule. So remember this. Okay, so this is the reason why we have the so-called adenine, ATP, forming the energy base in our cells, not the other compounds. So, yeah, is this clear? Ye phosphate monodi triphosphate formation is clear? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes.
Everyone in the class. Agar kisi ko kuch doubt hai, bata dijiye. Because bio, this is basically a bio class, but today it's like chemistry. We have did some majority of the chemistry content itself. Okay. In case if somebody has any doubt in the structural formations, let me know. Okay, well, no doubts. No, fine then. We'll go ahead with the bonding. Now, I said DNA will be forming double structure, double helical structure. Okay. So, pehle double helical structure form hone ke liye, it has to first interact. So, the two chains of DNA should go for an interaction. So, when people studied the interaction patterns, okay, long back when people started discovered DNA and when people studied the interaction patterns, the interacting partners should be thermodynamically stable. Okay, so when they targeted a purine to base with another purine, like adenine say adenine, yeah, adenine say guanine, adenine say adenine ban raha tha. But that was actually not taking part in the so-called formation of your DNA chain or RNA chain. Same way, guanine and guanine also can form. Thymine and thymine also can form. I mean, the same pyrimidines, they can interact. Okay, but if you're trying them to interact with different pyrimidines or different purines, they can't. Adenine never goes for bonding with guanine. It's never. Okay? Adenine never pairs with guanine. Same way. Thymine never pairs with cytosine or uracil. And cytosine also never pairs with uracil or thymine. So, they never bond between themselves. They never bond between themselves. Okay? That's because of unstability. We can go for hydrogen interactions, but the distance matters. Okay? The closer the interacting partners, the greater the stability of the bond. Okay? So, at the same time, the farther the distance, the weaker the interaction. Okay, that's the basic reason. Okay, so whatever the kinds of the bonds they are forming here are basically hydrogen interactions. We have hydrogen bonds existing in nature. We have ionic bond, covalent bond. These two usually are considered as the strongest bonds. Okay, and apart from that, we have some weak forces of attractions like Van der Waals forces, like hydrogen bonds. Then we have these dative bonds or coordinate covalent bonds. Okay, polar bonds, these are all like weaker forces of attraction. Hydrogen bond is one such kind of a force. Okay, so when you're looking at the hydrogen bonding, definitely you should be having a hydrogen and an electronegative atom on the other side. Okay, so here we have electronegative atom appearing as oxygen, okay, and nitrogen in some cases. Okay, so it depends on the distance that they are coming across. Now, when I'm talking about distance, This is not just a simple base. This is connected to a sugar, okay? On a DNA chain, this is connected to a sugar. So when they are interacting, you also have to consider the phosphate and sugar orientations. Okay, when they are interacting, you also have to consider the sugar and phosphate. So these larger molecules, this entire nucleotide and this entire nucleoside should be considered. Okay, and when people studied, they actually observed that adenine goes for interaction only with thymine, okay, in case of DNA, and in case of RNA, thymine is replaced by uracil. Okay, in case of RNA, thymine is replaced by uracil. So adenine will be binding to thymine in DNA, or it will be binding to uracil in RNA. Okay, and the number of hydrogen interactions are 2. We have 2 hydrogen bonds. Okay, you can see the dotted structure here. This is your hydrogen interaction. Okay, and similarly, guanine always binds with cytosine. And the number of interactions are 3. So we have 1, 2, 3 hydrogen bonds formed between cytosine and guanine. So adenine always goes to T in DNA, guanine every time with C. Okay. Now there is one kind of a rule. Now as we are considering the molecule on the whole, okay. Ye sugar dekh lijiye, are the sugars on the in the same orientation or are they in the opposite orientation? Look at the figure and tell me, are the sugars in the same orientation or are they in the opposite orientation?
Opposite orientation. Opposite.
Yeah, look at the orientation of the sugar. The compatibility is in such a way that both the sugars should be opposite to each other. Okay, so that is the reason why you see in a DNA chain, you see this chain is running in this direction and this chain is running in the lower direction. So these two chains are not parallel. They are anti-parallel to each other. Okay, jab aapka DNA chains anti-parallel hoga, tab hi aapka bonding hoga. Okay, and how is the bonding happening? It's happening between A and T, and it's happening between cytosine and guanine. So this kind of an interaction is much stabler. Why it is much stabler? Collectively, you see they are forming multiple number of hydrogen bonds, and multiple number of hydrogen bonds together pose a very very big strength. Okay, and again that makes the DNA molecule much stabler. Okay, and RNA doesn't go for it, and hence RNA stays independent. Probably that's the reason why when you go for denaturing, the denaturation process is faster on RNA and it's very very slower on DNA. Okay, so this is how the interaction happens. Now look at the chains. Hum abhi yahan pe interaction mein we have actually seen that the chains are forming. How does this chain actually form? Okay, so the chain formation involves interaction of sugar and phosphate only. Hamara jab bhi DNA ya RNA ka chain banta hai, wo kaise banega? It's basically the sugar and phosphate interaction only. So how is this phosphate able to interact? We have earlier observed that one of the phosphate ester is interacting with fifth carbon, carbon number 5. When it has to go for forming a link, it again interacts with third carbon on the next sugar. So fifth carbon of first sugar, third carbon of next sugar. So this kind of a linkage, you see this is one ester, this is another ester. So we have 2 ester bonds here, and you call this as phosphodiester linkage or phosphodiester bond. Okay, so we have an ester bond here and we have an ester bond here. The ester is actually coming from phosphate, it's not carbon based phosphate ester, so it's phosphoester. So we have phosphodiester linkage established between the sugars. The first interaction is at fifth carbon and the second interaction is at third carbon. Same way, as you are prolonging the chain, again you have 5 and 3 interacting. So this way, 5-3 interactions, they go on. Okay, and this way, if you are going to look at the chain of the DNA, you see the formation. It goes from fifth carbon, it goes on, and ends at third carbon. Same way, it starts at fifth carbon, it goes on, and ends at third carbon. So this way, whenever you are indicating a DNA chain or a RNA chain, जब भी आप कोई nucleic acid का chain indicate करते हैं, you will be determining these positions, 5 prime and 3 prime. This indicates the starting of the chain and this indicates the end of the chain. 3 prime indicates the end of the chain, 5 prime indicates the starting of the chain. So 5 prime, 3 prime हम क्यों use कर रहे हैं, वो आपको समझ में आ गया? Did you guys understand? Everyone in the class?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So हमारा DNA chain जब बनता है या हमारा RNA chain जब बनता है, original component जो है nitrogen base, that is not interacting. It's actually the sugar that is interacting. Okay. It's sugar and the phosphate that makes the chain of your DNA or RNA. Okay. So this way हमारा जब chain बनता है, so see we have the direction of synthesis always happening from 5 to 3. Remember, it is always from 5 to 3. It's not from 3 to 5. It begins at 5th carbon and it ends at 3rd carbon. It never begins at 3rd carbon. Okay, it always ends at 3rd carbon. It always begins at 5th carbon. 5 is the starter, 3 is the ender, finisher. Remember that. Okay, like in cricket game, we see that Rohit Sharma is the so-called beginning batsman. And usually the game gets finished by Yuvraj Singh or Dhoni. Okay, so consider that way. Let's say Rohit Sharma is the 5 prime end and Dhoni or Yuvraj Singh is your 3 prime end. So this way you try to remember it. Okay, and this is how usually the match proceeds, and the same way the DNA chain or RNA chain proceeds in the same manner. Okay, so we stop here for today. Humne structure but pad liya hai. So in the next class, we will be studying about different phenotypic properties of DNA and different properties of RNAs. And then we will be comparing both of them together. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So you can all disperse. Chavi present. Okay. Yeah, some of you have actually joined late. Please give your attendances.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, rest of you all can leave. Chavi, you are present. Fine.
Thank you, sir.
33 is present. Soren Mukherjee, okay.